Continuous emission and absorption spectra. Let's start by looking at the continuous spectrum. If you shine white light through a prism, you'll see all the frequencies of visible light, starting with low energy, long wavelength, low frequency red light, up to high energy, high frequency, short wavelength, violet light. So next we look at the emission spectrum. If you view a hot gas through a prism, you'll see colored lines on a black background. If we compare a continuous spectrum, which shows all the frequencies of visible light, then an emission spectrum shows only certain frequencies of visible light. And finally, we look at the absorption spectrum. If you view a cold gas through a prism, you'll see black lines on a colored background. If we compare an emission spectrum with an absorption spectrum, where we have the colored lines on the emission spectrum, we have the black lines on the absorption spectrum. Here we have some emission line spectra for different elements. We have hydrogen, sodium, helium, neon, and mercury. And what you can see is that each element has its own unique line spectrum, just as each person has their own unique fingerprints. So these line spectra can be used to identify unknown elements.